tonight on 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown. Sean Locke, Richard Iowati, Joe Wilkinson, Ashling B, Tom Allen, Susie Dent, Rachel Riley, and your host, Jimmy Carr.
Hello and welcome to 8 out of 10 Cats Does Countdown, a show all about letters, numbers and conundrums. So let's meet tonight's players. First up, it's Sean Locke. Thank you. Sean Locke has a love-hate relationship with Countdown. He hates it when he's on it, but he loves it when he's not. And joining Sean tonight, Joe Wilkinson. You may know Joe from various panel shows and sitcoms, or from the episode of Spring Watch, where he was discovered nestling in some brambles by Kate Humble.
I'm happy with it.
Up against them this evening, it's guest team captain Richard Iowati. Richard Iowati, he's as awkward as going to kiss your nan goodbye and her slipping you the tongue. And Richard's teammate, Ashling B. Ashling B is from Ireland, but we don't like stereotypes on this show, so I've been through the script and removed all references to Guinness, four-leaf clovers and leprechauns. In fact, I went through it twice, to be sure, to be sure. Joe, it was your birthday recently. Do you have a nice birthday?
No. I am getting old, aren't I? And don't know if you know this, but when you get older, your testicles start hanging down. Well, I didn't think mine had started to hang that low. Well, I didn't until I walked down my hallway in just my dressing gown and one of my plums knocked over a Wellington boot.
So.
No, it wasn't a good birthday, no.
Some of those hunter wellies are quite tall,
yeah,
though, aren't they?
Yeah, that's the only thing that kept me going. Yeah. Big old wellies.
Richard, are you going to make a good leader this evening? You're team captain.
Here's the thing. How dare you?
Sorry.
Here's the thing with leadership that I feel is that once you have seized power, really all you have to do is coast and preside over the decline and blame others. And I'm going to do that. So I think I'll be a good leader in that respect. And if something difficult comes up, I'll put it to the public.
Lil Dicky, I Thank got you. Your back.
Thank you.
Lil Dicky, I like.
Do you? Wow. I think we're fine.
Yeah. Good. Ashling, now you've been spending a lot of time in the US recently. Have you enjoyed living there?
Yeah, but I'm still the same old Irish girl I've always been, Jimmy.
What part of America were you staying in?
And also, are we in slow motion?
You can do an American accent, though, can't you?
Of course.
Yes, of course. Yes.
Is this it?
Let me. No, I do the Irish accent here because it sets me apart, but really I'm from Scunthorpe.
Sean, you are, without question, a very, very beautiful man. If you were in a beauty pageant, what would your special talent be, Sean?
That old chestnut. Well, obviously, the swimsuit section, the ability to hide my testicles would be a great skill.
How do you...?
Well, I don't actually go in for beauty pageants.
What?
It's a question, isn't it?
And you said your ability to hide your testicles...
Would be,
but you don't hide your testicles.
No, but I'm going to continue...
Well, be careful. If they're out and about, they might knock over a welly. Yeah.
Do you mean that you'd hide them within your own person, or like a squirrel, you'd put them in a tree and maybe one in a hedge for winter?
I don't think I'd get myself into this situation. Getting back to your question, beauty pageant. I'm actually trying to bring it back, the beauty pageant.
Really?
Yeah, because there's a lot of opposition to it, but I'm going to do it on the radio. I think people will accept that.
It's a very good idea.
But still have the swimsuit bit. On the radio.
Also, sometimes it's nice when you're talking about the swimsuit bit not to do that. In the voluntary, were you in the swimsuit bit, you know? OK, do you have a mascot this evening?
Yes, I do. You know how people use balloons to convey special messages, important messages?
Yeah.
Happy birthday, you've had a baby boy, baby girl. That's about it, really, isn't it? I think they're wasted as balloons. I think they're very powerful deliverers of messages. And I think we can use them in a more healing way in society and announce perhaps things about ourselves that we're not necessarily proud of, but not, not ashamed of either. So, for example, this one here. This is a balloon that I've come up with, I think, which will sell very well. Starts off with congratulations.
More classic.
But if a breeze catches it and it spins round, it's because the fatwa has been lifted. Now, who wouldn't want to celebrate news like that? You've literally just put the phone down to the Ayatollah. And you tell your friends, and they think, well, how do we mark this? You go down to Clinton's, buy one of these. Another thing that might be useful, how do you tell someone you've been in a relationship with them that things aren't working out? Mm. Often they come home from work and they'll see, like, a suitcase packed. It's a very harsh message, isn't it? Mm. Whereas if you had this tied to a chair... You sit there like that. And, but this is my favourite. Super gonorrhea.
Richard, have you got a mascot?
Yeah.
What have you got?
The film White Chicks.
What?
Have you seen this film, White Chicks?
I've not seen this film.
Oh, it's a heck of a film. I rewatched it recently.
What's, remind me what happens in White Chicks.
Okay, so it is a wonderful thing. Two FBI people, men, they go undercover posing as two socialites, white socialites. I don't know that you need to say white in front of socialite, actually. but they go... they go undercover as white women, socialites, as I say, in order to prevent them being kidnapped. And what it does is it really allows a marvellous opportunity to see things from a woman's point of view. And if you see White Chicks, I think you'll really understand what it is to be a woman.
An excellent mascot.
So that's
Joe, have you got a mascot this evening?
Yeah. I, you've probably heard I've started designing my own range of motorcycle helmets. So I brought in a few of my latest designs. This first one I call 56-year-old marketing manager from Leicestershire. Classic little design.
I mean, he does look quite a lot like me.
Oh, yeah, sorry about that. Do you want to try one?
Of course.
Just looks like your head's swollen. Oh,
just perfect, so people will still recognise me even when I'm on a motorbike.
You just became a Russian doll, briefly.
this one's nice if you're a sports fan or you're going to a wedding. Quite nice, isn't it? You like that, Sean?
Yeah. What about bridges?
Shit. Oops. Bit annoying, I can't get it off.
That was nice.
Please.
Thanks for playing.
Thank you, Daddy.
Any other designs people can get excited about?
My last design it comes in a pair, and it's for kind of motorcycle sidecar guys. Sean, do you mind modelling one of these?
Mm.
I call these testies. So, here you go.
Oh, God. Hey, put your heads down.
Yeah, one should be a little bit lower than the other.
if you put your faces right down on the thing and then I stand like that, does that look like I've got...
I mean...
It's actually quite humiliating.
I like it.
Thanks.
I feel like people just switching on now go, oh, I thought Embarrassing Bodies was on tomorrow. They are massive, though.
Yeah, they're based on Nick Hewers.
Aisling, have you got a mascot?
Well, yes, Jimmy. I am really going to try hard today, and I know that it's all about the three C's, comedy, accounting and spelling. And... my mascot is just down here, so, Little Dickie, if you wouldn't mind covering for me for 2 seconds.
You've got the small talk guy right here.
Yeah, just... like, banter away with some of your witty anecdotes.
Yes, White Chit starts with the two... the two undercover FBI people posing as Mexicans. And they do some wonderfully sensitive material at the start.
But the done now, Richard! It's all fine. They say, Jimmy, dress for the job you want, not for the job you have. Bonsoir, Rachel. and so this is me for the maths. 40 minus 60. Well, obviously, that can't be done. It's impossible. and then for the old... because it's not just about numbers, is it, Rachel?
Well...
OK, that's one person. It's also about words, Susie.
Wow.
It's me, Susie Dent. Wow.
I think any impression that starts with the name of the person you're doing is great.
And then, obviously, you can't just focus on numbers and words, can you? It's also about having a couple of jokes. So I thought, who better to emulate than my hero...
It looks like Susie Denton's gone lesbian, is what it looks like.
Which, funny you should say that, Jimmy, because that's how people talk about you behind your back. It's me, Jimmy Carr. Hey, why did the chicken cross the road? Because your mum's fat.
I liked it. OK, and over in Dictionary Corner, it's Tom Allen.
Yeah!
Tom Allen is a comedian, actor and writer, but you probably know him best from his work on popular children's board game Guess Who? I like the fact you put your head down there as if it's...
Yeah.
Is he bald? No. Nice. Tom, you've kept us up to date with your love life in the past. How's that going?
Not very well. I've joined some of those dating apps and on one of them recently, somebody started a conversation with me by sending me a photograph of their asshole. What are you supposed to respond to that? I put, what an opening.
Very good.
I'm meeting him for dinner next week. I don't know how I'm going to recognise him.
And with Tom, of course, it's Susie Dent.
Yay!
Some people have said I'm unduly mean about Susie Dent's books. They ask me, how do you sleep at night? Well, the secret is I have one of Susie Dent's books next to my bed, so I'm out like a lice. Susie, we've got Richard Iowardi on the show this evening. Do you have any favourite nerdy words or phrases?
Nerdy words? Well, I like the word geek, because I'd call myself a geek. proudly, which you call yourself a geek, but geeks used to be these freaks, so they would perform in freak geek shows and they would like stick needles through their hand and they'd bite their heads off live chickens, put strange things in their bodies. So it's what? Come a long way since then.
Has it, though?
You'd have to ask Richard.
God, while you were saying geek, Susie, I was like, do you know what I'll do? I'll look up geek really quickly in the dictionary. There's so many words in here. It takes ages, doesn't it?
Well, they are in order.
That makes more sense.
And in charge of the numbers, it's Rachel Riley.
Hey, it's so good.
Mathematician, physicist and all-round brain box, there really is no end to the talents Rachel Riley squandered standing in front of a whiteboard in a cocktail dress. OK, now, it was recently National Numeracy Day. I was not made aware. How did you celebrate?
Some of the other comedians actually were made aware. I got them to do little videos for me. I got Joe and I got Aisling and asked them about their feelings towards numeracy and then I gave them some countdown tips. So basically, they should be really, really good at the countdown numbers game
now. What are the countdown tips?
Well, they're all written down. They're like proper maths tips. So hopefully, they've been practicing. And now,
can you say them out loud?
Well,
it's not the magic circle. It's maths.
Well, it's like the things like, you know, you say, I know my 93 times table, but you just need your 100 times table and your 7 times table, and you put them together, and that's
107.
Well, basically, now I should have holiday cover if I ever need to go away.
Nobody will ever know, Rachel.
Some people may know.
Magic
but she can
TV,
do the voice.
Guys.
You can do the voice, can't you?
Yes, I can. Would you like a little one from the top and a big one from the bottom?
OK, the prize the Chiefs will be competing for tonight is this, the Countdown Leaf Blower. OK, let's count down, everyone. Time for the first game. Richard and Aisling, you get the first pick of the letters.
We'd like a vowel, please, Rachel.
We would.
And, like, three more as well.
So four
Eight.
Vowels.
Yeah.
OK.
Yeah.
And then can we get the rest in consonants, please?
T.
Gosh. Oh, crumbs. Should I be writing this down?
Yes, see if this is.
Whoa.
And V.
And for the first time today, here's the countdown clock.
Right, come on.
But you know what? Don't worry if the dog pees on that dress. We've got a spare. OK. Richard, how many letters?
Six letters.
Six. Aisling, how many letters?
I've got a six as well.
A six as well, OK.
Yeah.
Sean?
Six.
Six, OK. Joe?
Six.
Have you just said six because everyone else has said six?
Yeah.
What's your six, Joe?
I was hoping you'd ask them first. I've got five. Timer.
Timer. OK. Sean, you're six?
Master.
OK, nice. Mm. Richard, you're six?
Voters.
All solid. Aisling.
My one's great, and the wig, Susie, worked. stereo.
Oh, that's wonderful.
There's only one E for
sure.
Oh,
no!
Whoa, be quiet now.
OK, so what's 6 points to both teams? Tom, I've got a couple of questions for you over there in Dictionary Corner. Firstly, why didn't you reply when I sent you a picture of my arsehole? Secondly, could they have done any better?
I did. Yes, of course they could have done better. They could have had Atomizer, of course, you dummies. Which is one of those things that puts perfume on, I think.
OK, on to our first numbers round. Sean, Joe, your turn to pick the numbers.
Can I
pick?
Go on, Joe.
Can I have...
Run wild, run free.
All four corners. Middle, third along, and whatever you want.
Lovely. Sure to be happy with that. Right, got four little, and they are 7, 5, another 5, and 6, and 2 big, 150. And the target, 419.
And your time starts now. OK, the target was 419. Joe, did you get it?
I got 400. I'm sticking with that.
OK. Sean, did you get it?
421.
421, so just two away. Richard, did you get it?
I looked at them for a while and I thought, this is a nightmare. And then I added most of them up. It wasn't close.
Well, thanks for talking us through that. Aisling, did you get it?
I was only about 40-odd off.
OK, so, Sean, you were the closest. 421, how did you do it?
5 times 100.
5 times 100, right.
100. 500 minus 50.
450. Oh, yeah.
7 times 5 is 35, take that away.
415.
And then add 6.
Yep, 2 away, well done.
Could I say that I actually got 420? I thought I got 451, but I actually got 420, so the wig worked, Rachel.
So you got 421. You're now, a late call, you're saying you got 420.
Yes, I just didn't realise.
All right, well, how did you do that?
So I multiplied 7 by 6, which is 42,
yeah,
and 5 by 5, which is 10, and then I multiplied 42 by 10, and I got 420.
Yeah. One away, well done.
OK, we'll give it to you. 7 points to Aisling. Rachel... 419. Now, I think there's a couple of ways you could do this.
There are a couple
of ways. Did you spot it?
50 times 6 is 300.
Yes.
300 times 7 is 2,100.
Yeah. Oh, you're way off. I'd stop there if I was you. You're making a tit of yourself.
2,095. And divide it by the other 5. And you get 419.
Wow. Yep.
OK, so Sean and Joe have 6, Richard and Aisling have 13.
Yeah,
and here is your teaser. The words are nice grip. The clue is you may feel a small prick. That's nice grip. You may feel a small prick. See you after the break. The answer to the tease, the words were nice grip. The clue was you may feel a small prick. It was, of course, piercing. OK, they've been playing in team so far, but this game is just for Sean and Richard. So, Sean, it's your turn to choose the letters.
OK. Mind. Can I have a consonant, please, Rachel?
Thanks, Sean. G.
And then a vowel?
E.
And then a consonant?
S.
And then a vowel?
U.
And then a consonant?
L.
And then a vowel.
I.
Then a consonant.
P.
Another consonant, please.
N.
And then another consonant.
And the last one, K.
And your time starts now. OK, Sean, how many?
Don't know whether they've got a five or a risky six.
Ooh.
Thank you, Joe.
I mean...
Just underline the word penis.
I think I just have to play it safe, Jimmy. Five I'm going for.
You're going for five?
What are you up to?
Penis spunk.
I can't believe we're clapping spunk.
I feel like I might have caused this.
Richard, how many letters?
Well, look, given that there was a five...
Yeah.
I have a definite six, I feel.
OK. So what was your five, Sean?
Lynx.
Do you know what I like about this look on Richard, if you don't mind me saying, babes?
Sure.
Is that very much like your movie.
White Chicks.
Yes.
Let's keep it relevant.
Yes. This looks very much like you dressing up as a sort of, like, girl who's like, oh, I don't know, I could never go out with anyone in the football team.
Exactly.
But then, like...
There's a transformation.
Oh, my giddy
up! I see. Thank you. So what was your sex, Richard?
Puking.
Is that actually a word?
Yeah, puke.
To puke is actually a word.
Are you surprised that puke is in the dictionary?
Yes! So is there such informal language in the OED?
Yeah, because that's more often than not, that's what you want to look up, isn't it? Because you don't...
Was that all that you're doing as well? Just looking up, like, dickwad and stuff?
OK, so 6 points to Richard.
Thank you.
Now.
Yeah.
OK, now. Tom, Susan. Could they have done any better?
And there is an eight there, scalping, giving what? Someone a smack.
OK, so at the end of that, Sean and Joe have six, Richard and Aisling have 19. OK, right now, time for Joe and Aisling to go head-to-head. Aisling, your turn to pick the numbers.
Oh, great. Woohoo! Here I go! could I have one from each corner, please, Rachel?
Yep.
And then two from the middle.
That'll do.
Yeah.
Three, six, two, five, 75 and 50.
Oh, shit.
And the target, 961.
Oh, give up.
Oh. Mate.
OK, smiles your time starts now.
Mate.
The target was 961. Nine. Joe, did you get it?
1,000.
Aisling, did you get it?
Yes, Jimmy, I got it. Yes.
So turn us water dead.
I took the 75 there. And I times it by six.
Of course you did, my dear.
And I got 450 there.
Add the tree.
The what, sorry?
The tree.
There is a tree!
And times add by two.
Multiplied it then, did you? And then, what did that get you?
Well, Rachel, you, I mean, you can get it from there, can't you?
I don't want to patronise the girl, Jimmy.
906.
Of course.
And then just add on the 550 there.
And so you get yourself...
Well, no, you've run out of room, didn't count.
So you get, nine...
The clue really
six,
would be the number that's written
one.
Up there.
Yes! She's only bloody got a dollar.
Yes, that's...
Wait a second.
That's exactly how Marlon Wayans is unveiled in the fashion show in the finale of White Chicks.
Thanks, Richard. I was really looking forward to seeing that film.
Joe, what did you get?
Nine, five, six.
OK, so how did you do it?
Five times two.
Five times two, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, no, that's bloody wrong already. Oh, no, 10. That's 10. 10.
Oh, Jesus.
Okay, we need this.
I jumped ahead a bit.
John's not here, and I'm fucking losing again.
And then I did. this is bad even for me. I did times 50, which I then just jumped to that being 1,000, which is not. Then I added a 50 and a 6.
556.
That's absolute dog shit.
Okay, let's have you swap back. No points to anyone.
Oh. Wow.
Okay, time to go across to Dictionary Corner. Tom, what have you got for us?
Oh, thank God for that. Now, I'd like to talk about something that's been ruining a lot of weekends and spare time. That's right, children. A lot of my friends insist on having them and they won't stop going on and on and on about them. Some of them even make me hold their newborns. Oh, Tom, support the head, they say. Support the head. Don't give it to me if the head's not screwed on yet. And of course, when children are given to me, they instantly cry because they see the poison in my soul. Now, these horrible little monsters, I mean children, sometimes will insist on giving me their pictures and drawings that they've done. So I've decided to use this quiet moment to give them some constructive feedback through the medium of national television. Now, this first one is from Alistair. Now, Alistair is 6 years old. There he is. And he has drawn me a picture. It is clearly rubbish. I know some of you will be saying, oh, well, maybe it's a young Picasso. I don't think Picasso ever used PVA glue and pipe cleaners outside of the bedroom. And let's have a closer look at those hands, shall we? Have you ever seen hands like that? Why, they're bigger than your mother's head. And I know your mother. She has very dainty hands and a very, very large head. For our next one, this is from Cynthia. Cynthia is 8. She likes ponies and daisies and drawing crappy pictures. And this next one, I'm reliably informed, is supposed to be a picture of me. What is this, some sort of taunt by making it out of pasta? You know I can't have carbs before marbs. And is this supposed to be my immaculately contoured beard? It looks like I've literally rubbed shit in my face.
She should really have just drawn a face on an egg, shouldn't she?
Maybe.
How did you make that so flirty?
It's the spring. In conclusion, children, work harder. Don't be so lazy. What are you even doing after 3 p.m? I know what you're doing. You're watching Paw Patrol and getting jam on things. It's not good enough. Pick up your game. This bullshit will not do. Thank you.
Well, well done, everyone. And here is your teaser. The words are Nip's Edge, and the clue is, let's take things slow. That's Nip's Edge. Let's take things slow. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were Nip's Edge. The clue was, let's take things slow. It was, of course, speeding. OK, on to another letters game, and it's time to ramp up the tension. It's time for the tension round. In this game, we're playing for double points, so the pressure's on. Yeah, the tension round. He does that every time I say the tension round. If we needed it. Okay, Joe, can you show me what does your face look like when you're stressed?
I taught him everything he knows about acting.
I think you'd be good in the biopic of the Bee Gees.
Oh, thank you.
Don't know which one.
I could do all three.
Yeah.
Like Eddie Murphy in...
Nutty yeah. Professor 2, The Clumps.
Yeah.
It's no White Chicks, but it's good.
OK, Richard and Aisling, go ahead and pick the letters.
OK, I'm going to drop a vowel on me, Rachel.
Dropping A.
Yeah.
E.
Consonant.
D. Mm-hmm.
Vowel and vowel, please.
O. Did you want two?
OK.
A.
A.
Two consonants.
G. N.
And then, let's say it at the same time. We would like a...
Vowel.
I. This is looking good.
Then we'd also like a... Consonant. Yep.
And then just to end it now. In some way. Vowels.
A.
OK, for double points, your time starts now. Smooth under tension there, Aisling. Really, really style that one out. Well done.
Oh, God, I'm so close to shitting myself.
You've got my nerves.
Joe, how many?
A risky 8.
Very risky, I would say.
Yeah.
Sean?
5.
5, OK. Aisling, how many?
Oh, wow.
I've got 8.
8, OK. Richard?
I'll go for the 5.
OK, all right, what's your 5?
Podge.
Podge. Nice word, podge. OK. Sean, your 5?
Doing.
Doing.
No, doing.
Either is fine.
Joe, you're risky. Probably not a word. 8.
Pedoing.
You're not going to believe this.
Have you got the same word?
I also got pedoing.
Do you want me to use it in a sentence?
Susie, I have a feeling it won't be in there. Is it in there?
It's not there, it's a verb.
What?
No. That's a problem.
Shame.
Yeah, it is.
OK, so double points, 10 points to both teams. Tom, Susie, could they have done any better?
Doping.
Would dog nap have worked?
Dog nap?
Oh, dog nap.
Yes, very
I
good.
Told you to say dog now.
Very good.
And I had it. Look. I no, that's puking. I wrote... no, that's 150. I did write it down.
You had it there. I saw it.
You
saw
it.
I can't find
oh,
it.
Oh, you're... It's all screwed.
Do you want me to write dog nap on here?
Where's the paper? Is it...
Dog nap.
Dog nap. Yeah, I could see it. Dog nap. Time now to go across the victory corner. Tom, what have you got for us?
Well, everyone loves cooking for friends. Dinner parties are a great way to show off, get your temper up, and make your friends feel awkward about why you've gone to so much trouble for just one meal. I mean, you could have gone out, right? So here's my method for a perfect dinner involving a roast chicken. Uh-huh. So what I thought we'd do is a little cooking segment. I'm going to put on marigold gloves. So take your chicken and put it into a tray. Talk at your partner in a way that's brimming with anger, but not actually shouting. For example, Mike, can you just give me a minute, please? I need to deal with the chicken. Place half a lemon inside the cavity with some herbs. Next, stop for a moment to look out the window and contemplate, is this it? I mean, sure, I'm happy, but I just thought there'd be more than this.
Oh, potatoes.
Now, take some softened butter and put it under the skin of the breast. Then, go to the kitchen door and shout, Mike, where are you? I'm not doing all this on my own, am I? Do you think I want to spend all afternoon in the kitchen doing this, do you? Do you think that, do you? And then season liberally with salt and pepper. When Mike returns, don't look at him. And sharply ask him to open the oven door. Open the oven door, please, Mark, I've got my hands full! Ignore his crestfallen look if he asks what's the matter. And by now, the atmosphere will be really cooking. Place in a preheated oven and cook for ages. When it's ready, leave it to rest in your second oven. If you don't have a second oven, maybe you should have worked harder at school. Finally, take your chicken to the table. Amongst much jubilation and clapping and cheering, give Mike a quick, short, sharp look to let him know you're still not happy. Everyone will be embarrassed, but not sure why. Then get blackout drunk and have to be helped up the stairs to bed at around 8:30 p.m. And remember, don't ever let them see you cry.
Tom Allen, everyone. And here is your final teaser. The words are rad minge. The clue is, I do it in bed. That's rad minge, I do it in bed. See you after the break. Welcome back. The answer to the teaser, the words were rad minge. The clue was, I do it in bed. It was, of course, dreaming. OK, time for our final letters game. Sean and Joe, your turn to choose the letters.
Vowel, please.
E.
Consonant. Do you want to choose?
R.
No.
Vowel, please.
O.
Consonant.
T.
Oh, come on.
Consonant.
D.
Consonant.
S.
Vowel.
U. Oh.
Consonant.
L.
Standing ovation at the end of this.
And consonant.
Oh. And the last one, P.
OK, and your 30 seconds starts now. Aisling, how many?
Six.
Six. Richard?
Six.
Six, OK. Sean?
Six.
Six, six, six. Speaking of beasts, Joe?
four.
Yeah, four.
OK, what's your four?
Stud.
Sean, your six?
Pulsed.
OK, Richard, your six?
Two doors.
Is that in there,
Susie? I think it might be capitalised only.
Shut the fridge.
What about Tudors? Tudor period. Tudors.
Yeah, all capitalised.
This is some frickin' bullshit.
Aisling, I mean, it's really up to you here. What's your six?
Stored.
Stored?
Yep.
Can't argue with that. 6 points to both teams.
Yay! Yay.
Tom, could they have done any better?
They could have done better, yes, Jimmy. They could have obviously had splurted.
OK, so Sean and Joe have 22, Richard and Aisling have 35.
Yes.
You're blaming me, aren't you? Sean's blaming me for this share of shit. I can tell it in your
well,
eyes.
Well, your conundrum is just for pride.
Well, we could make it a tension round.
And if I say tension round? Nothing. Oh.
What if you say attention?
No. Nothing.
Make a tension round.
All right, let's make it. And you know what? We will.
Yay! Yay!
Okay, so 20 points on offer. Yeah. Fingers on buzzers. It's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum.
I just get hurt.
Put the pen away.
Okay.
You've got to use that.
Okay, can everyone shut up while I do my linky bit? basically. OK.
Jimmy, but that outfit's lost you quite a lot of authority. Yeah.
OK, fingers on buzzers. It's time for today's crucial countdown conundrum.
These are bullshit.
20 points on offer. Your time starts now. Okay, let's have a look and see what it was.
It was, of course.
Well, it means that Richard and Aisling are the righteous winners. Okay, so the final scores. Sean and Joe have 22 points, but tonight's winners with 35. It's Richard and Aisling. Congratulations, you're now the proud owners of this, the Countdown Leaf Blower. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience, and all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.
Wednesday night at 10, we start our brand new comedy drama, a coming-of-age tale with Marnie struggling with her mental health and having thoughts that are anything but pure. Coming up next tonight, it's back, it's live, and it's unpredictable as ever. I get the feeling Brexit might just get a mention. The last leg is on the way.